February is known for Month of Romance, but it's also February Heart Health Month. I'm Jamie Lee McIntyre, and I'm the registered dietitian at Grade A ShopRite. Of course, around this time of year, we like to show our love to those we care about, and often this is through chocolate and candy. Take this small box of chocolates here. For just three small pieces, it'll cost about 160 calories and 16 total grams of fat. When you're preparing your sweet treats for your Valentine this year, consider some healthier options. Try this healthier alternative to the chocolate cherry candies I showed you earlier. I used 2/3 cups of dried cherries. I'm going to add another cup of slivered almonds, unsalted, and then just a teaspoon of pure vanilla extract, a dash of salt, and of course the unsweetened cocoa powder to give it that nice fudgy chocolatey taste. And I'm putting in about 4 tablespoons. And just a few pitted dates. I'm going to start with 5 or 6 and see if that is enough moisture. Once I've got that all in there, I'm going to blend it up. And then just take a little clump and roll it in your palms. And I would refrigerate right away and at least a good 10-20 minutes before serving. My chocolate cherry almond delights will be tart, sweet, and of course chocolatey. And instead of providing so many calories without any nutrients, you'll get a dose of fiber and up to 17 different antioxidants from those dried cherries. A healthy store-bought option is to go for some dark chocolate bars as opposed to milk or sugary chocolate bars. What you want to look for is a chocolate bar that's at least 70% cocoa, and that chocolate's going to be one of the first ingredients listed as opposed to sugar or cream or milk. Like these endangered species, 72 and 88% dark chocolate candy bars. Just 1 ounce a day, of course in moderation, can provide cardiovascular benefits and help prevent heart disease. A fun way to get the kids involved and have them enjoy the sweets of the holiday is to make these fun fruit kebabs. I took just some chopped up mango, melon, and pineapple, and I've added some berries at the ends. And you can use a skewer or just a straw like I'm using here today. And of course, you'll want some dip for these. My chocolate Greek yogurt dip starts with an individual serving of plain non-fat Greek yogurt. I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of the unsweetened cocoa powder and just 1 teaspoon of a liquid sweetener like agave, honey, or maple syrup. And I like to do just a little drop of vanilla as well. I'm going to mix that all up together. This works with both Greek yogurt and regular yogurt. We're going to start with just some sugar-free chocolate pudding, already made. Of course, you can whip up your own instant or cook some on the stove if you have time to refrigerate it. And these I just grabbed from the frozen section. They're sliced frozen strawberries allowed to defrost. And you can top it off with just a little bit of whipped cream. And I like to call this strawberry swimming in chocolate. I hope you enjoy a heart-healthy and happy Valentine's Day.